Night Cafe could be as easily a realist work or an impressionist work as a post-impressionist piece until you start digging into it. What we see is an apparently benign subject depicted with a charged air of near mania. He tries to achieve an oppressive air, a place where one can ruin oneself, go mad, or commit a crime. And he's doing it in a very specific way. The madness of the place is depicted through the vivid colors and complementary juxtapositions that we see throughout. It's also depicted in the high impasto that we see him working with the paint. So in other words, this very high texture that he achieves with the paint, he applies it very, very thickly and very, very rapidly. So when we look at the expressive quality just of his paint application, we get a sense of someone who is desperate to get an image out. And he's doing this all at once. This is a la prima, and that's part of the reason we see this very thick application of paint. Some of his paintings are actually thick enough that the paint is still soft to this day. So let's look at the image. How does he give us this really awkward period, this really awkward scene? Well, as we look at, first of all, nothing here is comfortable. This is not the bar in Cheers. This is some place that you walk into and you walk back out of. Let's pull up my pen and we'll walk around it. When we look at the figures, we notice that the people are all, well, sad, depressed, something's going on. These figures seem to be almost passed out at the bar. Here's another figure the same way. And we can see from the clock that it's probably somewhere around 12:10, 12:15 at night. It's a late hour. People are not out enjoying themselves. In fact, just the opposite. These two seem to be having a quiet conversation, but it's not a positive one. After all, they're sitting next to each other. This is a position that one sits in to comfort one another, not a position one sits in when you're trying to be intimate with someone, trying to get to know someone particularly closely. Usually we want that eye contact. If you're breaking up with someone, however, you sit next to them because you don't want the eye contact. And the bartender himself, well, he doesn't seem to want us there in any way, shape, or form. He's a little bit distorted and awkward. Speaking of distortion, look at the pool table or the chairs, and you'll notice that they're all just slightly distorted. They fall into that uncanny valley. It looks like a pool table, but it's definitely distorted. And that element of distortion makes us really uncomfortable. It's close, but it's not quite there. It's sort of 95% of the way. And that, added to the color, is going to make us very uncomfortable here. We have this yellow, and it's a sickly yellow hue over everything. Look at the green. We all are familiar with how green this pool table is, but here it takes on this yellow tone, as does the barman's outfit, which we know should be white, but here it's taken on the same sickly yellow. The lights, we get that radiant element around the lights, something that one doesn't typically see unless high on just the right kind of drugs. And then we see the ceiling and the walls. Here, he's used complementary colors, bright green and bright red, that seem to irritate us. You couldn't imagine actually painting your place in these colors. If you did, you'd probably go mad, just like you would in the Night Cafe. And at the table, we see what appears to be a bottle of absinthe, which was believed to bring on madness in people should they drink too much. It was felt that it would cause hallucinations and problems. It was known as the green ghost. So all of this together creates a certain energy. When we look at it, we get this sense of Van Gogh as manic at the time, as trying to get this image onto the canvas, trying to capture it. We get that sense of vibration and energy, but it's not a comforting energy. It's not, hey, I had a cup of coffee in the morning, I'm ready to work. It's, I had a cup of coffee and it's 2 a.m, and for the love of all that is holy, please let me sleep. And that's what we're getting here in Night Cafe. as he captures this very uncomfortable scene, he gives us a sense of how he feels about it. And that's important. He wants to get across his feeling on the image. This is what makes it so self-expressive. Unlike the Impressionists, who are at least capturing something in real color, more or less real color, Van Gogh says, you know what? I don't need to worry about the composition being perfect or the color being accurate. The important thing is that I'm expressing my feelings about this scene at the time the painting is done. That is what is so revolutionary about Van Gogh.